When people start things, my recommendation is you should start it with an output goal, not an outcome goal. So I use 100 as an example, but that 100 days could be 100 tweets. It could be 100 hours. It could be 20. It doesn't even have to be 100. But the idea is pick a thing and go, I'm going to do this X amount of times. If I launch a podcast, I might go, I'm going to put out 12 episodes of this podcast. I'm going to publish a new one once a week. And that's my goal. It's not about how many people listen to it. It's not about if I like it. I'm going to do it at the end of 12. I'm going to take a step back and I'm going to go, do I like doing this? Is it working? Do I want to keep doing it? When people don't approach it that way, from day one, they start thinking about, should I quit? They're constantly, should I quit? Should I not quit? Is it working? Was this a mistake? The other thing is, if they don't have an endpoint, it seems endless, which also makes them want to quit. Versus, well, I'm only doing 12. I said I'd do 12. At the end of 12, number one, they have a sense of accomplishment, even if nobody listened to it. Right. Because they're like, I said I was going to do 12. I did 12. When you do that, it frees you up. It removes all of the pressure of success that a lot of people feel right off the bat, which again is not realistic in most cases. It allows you to focus on the thing that is completely in your control. I can't control if anyone listens. I can't control if anyone buys. I can't control any of that, but I can control the output. So you have 100% chance of succeeding if that is the way you frame it. Whatever the number is that you pick, I highly recommend that approach, especially when you're starting something, because it just changes the whole dynamic. Because otherwise, I think people are constantly like, from like day one, should I quit and is this working?